Most of us don't think about our drinking water. We turn on the tap and there it is, ready to use. In the East Twin Cities metro, however, several communities have had their drinking water contaminated by PFAS. PFAS contamination was traced back to 4 disposal sites that affected about 150 square miles in the East Metro area. From the 1950s through the early 1970s, 3M disposed of PFAS waste at these sites. Some PFAS can build up in our bodies over time. The Minnesota Department of Health uses the best science available to develop guidelines to reduce long-term exposure and to ensure the water we drink is safe for everyone, especially babies. So how do we keep our drinking water safe? Let's journey through the tap. Most of the drinking water in the East Metro comes from aquifers deep underground. Water is pumped from wells and is delivered to you from a city water system or a private well. Cities make sure every drop of water that goes through their system is safe and meets all federal and state water quality requirements. So how do we treat PFAS in the drinking water? PFAS is a special contaminant that needs special testing and treatment. The Minnesota Department of Health and the Minnesota Pollution Control Agency work with communities that have city wells and individuals with private wells to identify and treat PFAS contamination. Granular activated carbon, or GAC, is very effective at removing PFAS. In Washington County, the GAC treatment systems have been shown to reduce PFAS to very low or non-detectable concentrations. With GAC treatment, water passes through a filter to remove PFAS. After some time, some PFAS may break through, at which point a secondary filter removes any PFAS that got past the first filter. These filters are checked and replaced regularly to make sure PFAS compounds are being removed. Next time you turn on your tap, remember, there's a lot that happens behind the scenes to make sure that you have safe and reliable drinking water.